doing might make them money. And it makes sense. Pull up this article, if you could, Bradley, from July of this year. House Speaker Nancy Pelosi's husband cashed in on big tech just as Congress was set to pounce. Scroll down a little bit. No, it's okay. This week before the House Judiciary Committee voted on reining in big tech, Speaker Nancy Pelosi's husband exercised a bullish bet on Google parent Alphabet, a timely transaction that netted him $5.3 million. The antitrust bill was advanced as a push by the government to curb the unregulated power of big tech firms Google, Amazon, Apple, and Facebook. It was the final part of a six-part package called Ending Platform Monopolies Act, aimed at restricting how big tech companies offer their products to ensure they don't use their size to dominate the market. I guess the details aren't that fully important there. That's all we really need to see. But this is not. This has happened before.
Allocate capital efficiently if, Richard Burr can't unload a whole bunch of hospitality stuff right before a pandemic, the full scale of a pandemic is known. Like, that's market 101.
And yeah, it's interesting too how are Pelosi and the Democrats able to deploy an attack effectively on that front when, say, Raphael Warnock and John Ossoff were running in the Georgia Senate elections. And it was Kelly Loeffler, I believe, who was engaging in brazen insider trading. When the Democrats have control of both chambers, Nancy Pelosi is not interested in doing anything to stop that because, as I mentioned, just this past year, one move by her husband was able to net her and him $5.3 million. And it's interesting because regular citizens who are made aware of non-public information prior to a trade, people go to jail for insider trading. I mean, everybody knows that's what Martha Stewart went to jail for. They are apparently not engaging in the free market in a way that is free. But members of Congress also have access to information prior to trades happening, and they're doing the same exact thing, except it's just sanctioned. The difference is because they make the laws. Martha Stewart, or the trader, who I'm not going to, cry a river for people who get convicted of insider trading, but the hypocrisy makes sense. Like,
should have been a lot more hit to roll into B science about Stewart.
Right. There are people on Wall Street.